I didn't mute us, and I'm waiting for it to show up. Over there it is. Okay.
Everyone, welcome to Heather's Art Adventures. I hope you're ready to have some fun.
Oh my goodness. Hello and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. I have to tell you guys, I almost hit the end broadcast button. I have done that. I have
it's going to be one of those days, you can tell.
Yeah, totally. I have actually done that once before. I've actually hit the end broadcast button. I think it's just because I'm doing something and then the first thing you see is this red button, right? And so I almost immediately go over there and hit that. And that has happened to me a couple times where I've hovered over it and went, oh, no, no, no. And I almost just did it without stopping myself just now. Anyway, hi. Welcome. Welcome to the show. We have Mert and Andrew and Jules are here with me. And I am so grateful because it sure makes my life a lot easier to have you guys here. Thank you. Thank you for being here. We have audience members, too. Lucy. Love having you in the audience. I'm really bummed that she's going back to work. I mean, it's probably a good thing. I'm not, this is like mixed emotions, conflicted. Yeah.
Well, it's good for her pocketbook, but not for those of us that love seeing her and hanging out with her every day.
Oh, I love watching her watch movies.
Yeah. Is she animated? I have yet to see I think we watched Mary Poppins together, but
she's quite animated.
Yes, she is.
She doesn't work at night, so I think she'll still be able to go to the
Yeah, she said yesterday she'll be able to make the movies, but she may be able to make this show because it doesn't start till half past five our time. I don't know what time she finishes work.
Oh, well, we'll take you even late, Lucy. You can show up any point in time. We will take you. So she's just laughing at us. Okay, I am really excited. First of all, oh, thank you, Mert. That's awesome.
I forget to subscribe. I come all the time, but I forget to subscribe. So I thought I might do that today.
Well, we appreciate you subscribing. There's a little thing that's supposed to pop up here, and you'll see it when we go to the desk. It pops up, and it doesn't have everybody's name in it because we have new subscribers. And it's manual process for me to add names to it. So I was like getting ready this morning and went, oh man, I got to add those names. Oh man, I got to get that done. Oh man.
So it has that automated.
Yeah, it should be, but it's not. It that's a whole nother mess.
Like you need another mess.
I don't.
That's good to know. Lucy finishes work at 4:30, so she should be able to make the shows.
Good. Oh my gosh. Okay. That is bonus because A, you get to go back to work and B, you still get to be here. So yay.
Yeah.
And I did put me second on that list. So
yeah, she says I'm gonna try my best to keep coming because I love coming here. We love having you too.
No, we love having you. And we were just talking about how important these little sessions are over at Mini Mert, because over, and I'm just going to put this in here for those of you who know, next week there won't be any Mini Mert, but it still is available tomorrow, right? You guys are still going to be there tomorrow.
Yeah, today is Thursday, Friday and Saturday are our last ones this week. And then because we'll be doing Genealogy Institute stuff for Pennsylvania Group, we are not doing any of our stuff next week.
Okay.
So we'll miss everybody. Okay.
And which is totally cool because if you sign up for this, right, we'll probably have some sort of notice or something. Maybe
well,
I'm speaking out of turn.
I use Zoom, so it gives it. You get one registration email. The last Zoom meeting I've scheduled is for Saturday, so I'm going to have to go in and extend it. Okay. No reminder emails. If you put it on your Google Calendar, you'll get a reminder. And that I recommend doing.
You know what else helps me too? When you have these recurring events like that, well as Monday matinee.
Yes.
When I open up my Zoom, it tells me this. I have a meeting today, and it has a blue join button for that meeting.
If it's a meeting, yes. If it's a webinar, which I do. We do two webinars every week. That doesn't work. In fact, it has it on the list, but when you click, it says, this is not a meeting.
Well,
enough of that.
I need webinars for the things I go to, I guess.
So what did you do yesterday with the jelly plate thing? It looks so cool.
Yeah, we're going to switch over to, I got to push the right button here. All right, we're switch over to the desk, and then I will put you guys like this. We'll see how that goes. And if you guys don't like that, we can move it. You guys let me know. But yesterday, here, let's see. First, I had mentioned yesterday that the flowers from my renewal of vow ceremony were so beautiful.
Yeah.
And I took this picture of it this morning. So they're still... They're not doing great, but they're still doing good.
So bright and cheerful.
Yeah.
Yes. And so I was so inspired by them that Monday morning, Greg and I were having coffee and I pulled out my my sketchbook. Let me go back to, too many buttons to push here. Where is it? Here it is. That's the button. Okay. So I pulled out my sketchbook and I started sketching. You can
bitties,
barely see this. Oh,
bitties, bitties.
I apologize, Jules. That was on my list and I didn't get it done. I apologize.
It's okay.
Don't hate me today, please. Don't hate me. I will try so hard to get it done today. Yeah, we're going to remove the bitties because it makes Jules unhappy. Okay, so I got out my sketchbook and I sketched some ideas that I know you can't really see, but like here's the big sunflower and the stems. And this is basically me sketching the bush, the what do you call that? Bouquet?
Bouquet.
Yeah, bouquet. Yeah.
Okay. I did that first and then I went, no, I think I want it to be more just like the sunflower front and center, but then that looked weird. So then I started adding little daisies and this is what I came up with. This is what we're going to be aiming for. I'm making several of these colors.
Yeah.
And I have some cutouts. They're die cuts that are words.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And you know, no word describes what happened this weekend more than blessed.
Oh,
so that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to cut out that die cut, but that's all to come. So this is where we went. We went from the inspiration in that picture that I showed you to this. And I'm thinking, okay, I'm going to do some jelly plate printing, specific colors to go into this beautiful collage art. And we started talking about collage art. This is actually, can you see that shimmer?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah. We started talking about the collage art. So I have yellows. I have some like reddish pinks. I pulled out some old jelly plates poles from previous sessions too. So we did some of this, much of this on camera, but then some of this has been done in other sessions as well. And we have some greens.
Is this regular paper or, you know, like printer paper? Well, I see some of it is on old books. Old book pages.
Yeah. So my favorite thing to do when I do collage art, I use three types of paper that are my favorite because you're going to be layering and the thinner, the better. And so I like to use regular copy paper. That's what this is. I like to use book pages. This is actually a Bible that was being discarded. And so rather than it had been water soaked. I know I get a lot of questions about, I can't believe you ripped up a Bible. It literally was going in the garbage and this was how I did it. And now I get to add the word of God into all of my art. So, so there's that. So that's page number two that I love to use. And then the third type of paper I love to use is called deli paper. And I know this is different in different parts of the world. So what do you guys call it, Jules?
We don't really use it. So we buy it off Amazon.
Yeah. I think I heard sandwich paper.
Yeah. They wrap up sandwiches at the deli in it. Yeah.
The deli. Yeah. We don't actually use it in the home.
Right. Right. And we don't really either. I don't know anyone personally who uses this outside of jelly plating in their home.
Right. I think that's a fair statement. Yeah.
Yeah, because now some people have said you can use parchment paper, but honestly, parchment paper is a little bit thicker and it does not have the same consistency as this. I've tried using it. It also has some kind of grease.
Parchment's got like a non-stick on it.
Yeah. Yeah. So this is called deli paper. I buy it in like 5,000 sheet box for like $15. And I think I've never bought another box since that one. I may need one now though, because I'm getting low, but anyway, so that, and then we have some blue, et cetera. So we just did it by color and now we're prepared and ready to do something. And I think Jules put in the link to my collaged art paper piecing. Remember yesterday I could not figure out the name of that?
Yes. You know how to do it, just not what you call it.
Yeah. So I'm going to screen share with you guys. This is that board. If you'd like to follow it, you may. Most of this is not my art, but there are a few pieces on here you might recognize as my art. But this is what I love to do with jelly plate poles. That's what we call these pieces of paper you just saw. Yeah. I prefer to do this. Now, you don't have to use jelly plate paper. Do you know that you could actually use like pattern paper for scrapbooking? You could actually paint your own papers using paintbrushes and stamps and markers and create your
look at the rooster or the dog. Oh my gosh, yeah. Those are cool.
There's some pretty amazing artists in here. And if you click on their links, hopefully they all take you to their thing so they get the credit for it, because there's a lot of things in here that I personally did not do. Uh-huh. But I love, love, love the work. I mean, this elephant, do you see? I'm just going to
make it a little bigger. Yes.
Yeah.
All those amazing, beautiful pieces.
Oh, wow. Look at that. Amazing. Even so, stamps.
Yeah.
Yep, exactly. So hopefully while you're looking at these awesome inspirational pictures here, you get some idea of where I'm going with today's art piece, and hopefully tomorrow as well, because there's no way we're getting done today. But yeah, and you can go as far as, like, this is a piece I did where I used an entire jelly plate pole to do the whole body.
Yeah, wow. It's amazing.
I remember that one.
Yeah, me too.
Or like that elephant had all those pieces. I mean, look at this. The highlight in the wine glass. That's just wicked to me. I love this. Okay.
Oh,
so
yeah.
This, when showing you these inspirational pictures, kind of puts me behind a bar here, because now I've got an image to live up to. But here we go.
Like, let's no pressure.
Right.
Wait, look at the cactus one that you did. It's at the top there, the second one in.
Yeah, I did that one.
You did that one, and it's
now amazing. I will say this is actually a really cool concept, because that entire thing was done with punches.
Yes.
Although I used the same deli paper or jelly paper that we did. Like we made yesterday, all the exactly. I cut out all the pages using butterflies, hearts, hexagons, circles, etc. And those are what's glued. So if you were to look at this up close, you'd see there's some butterflies in there and some hearts and stuff.
So
today we're not going to be doing that though. Today we're going to be tearing and cutting. So let's get
Can I just say that Melissa has joined us, so has Katie, and so has Mary.
Yay!
And Mary says the dragonflies are Heather's. They're Andrew's now.
Yeah.
Actually, she's lying to you. I'm sorry, Mary, but you're lying to everyone, because you know this print. I'm going to go back to this one. This one right here. Is actually Mary's. She just bought it.
Oh,
wow. It's gorgeous.
It's so funny. I was notified online that I had received a sale. And when I looked, I was like, oh, somebody bought the dragonfly. And then when I looked to see who it was Mary. I'm a big smile. Big smile.
Oh, well done, Mary.
So it was me calling her a liar, but that's not a terrible thing. I mean, it's terrible. Hopefully she forgives me for that one. That was kind of rude, I guess.
She says it is your work.
That's true. She's right. I love how you say it in that voice, too. Like you're scolding like she would. Right. Perfect. Yes, Andrew. Yes.
I've got a supply tip that I just thought about.
Okay.
I don't know whether anybody else has thought about it. A good source for patterned paper and stuff, go to your local friendly paint shop and ask them for their old wallpaper sample books.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Really good idea. I love that.
I just thought about it. I used to do work for Sherman Williams, and they would, I mean, you know, that's gorgeous paper. You get like 250 sheets, and they throw them out. They don't do anything else with them. One thing. Out of style, they throw them out.
I can't get anybody to ask for them for me.
Well, I don't know of any paint stores. I'll have to go look for a paint store or two, because that sounds like a good idea. I love the textured stuff.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You can use the textures on the jelly plate.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Awesome. Okay. I have these panels. They're 8x10. It's actually just like a little cardboard chipboard type of, it's very thick, but it has this sort of textured finish to it on one side.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
These were super cheap. I think I paid $1 for like 5 of them in a package.
Mm-hmm.
Cheap. So that's what we're going to use today.
Okay.
Anything. You can use anything. You can use old packaging even if you want to. So whatever you want. I've got a paintbrush. I've got my matte medium. I like to use matte medium to glue my papers down. And that's what we're going to start with. Okay. So let's start with the background because I feel like it's always easier to lay down and then build the layers up on top of. And if we start with the flower, then we have to piece around the flower. And to me, that's just too hard. I've done it that way before and then regretted it. So,
well, and the sky or the whatever is in the background in reality. So,
yes.
Yeah. Yes. Ooh, yeah. I love those blues and all that texture coming through.
Yeah. And when you see like the lace pattern from the stencil.
Yes. I can just see it.
Thing. Yeah. Yeah. So we are going to make a background that is paper pieced in blue because serendipitously, that funny word. Ooh, that's yellow.
You were expecting something else?
I was not expecting yellow, I can tell you that. All right, so switch to a different paintbrush. What was I saying? Oh, so the blue was like that dark blue, that color of my shirt, and it was also my cousin's dress that she was wearing.
Yes, I remember.
I felt like that needs to be the background. And she was so funny. She goes, "You're not wearing what he said you'd be wearing," but it worked out perfectly anyway.
It did. It did. I was like, "How did you guys match each other and look so well for those photos?" It just really,
So that's one of those funny stories. We're talking about my surprise renewal of wedding vows from the weekend, which was a total surprise to me. And the Mr. Crafter was so detailed. I was shocked by that because in our entire relationship, he is not the detail one. It's always me going, "Oh, that doesn't match. We're going to have to get a chain." He's like, "What doesn't match? Like, it doesn't even make sense."
I have a husband like that. He says, "This is just fine. We're going like this." I'm like,
right.
Then I kind of stick my lower lip out a little, and he's like, "Okay."
Right. I tell you from experience that they do listen and they do learn from that little lower lip thing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Okay. So, guys in the audience, listen up. These are their training tricks.
That's right. This is all free of charge, by the way. Free of charge right here. Nobody's even going to charge you for this valuable information. But yeah, he was so amazing to have such awesome details. And apparently he had taken a picture of the top that he wanted me to wear. And sent that to Heidi. So she knew what I'd be wearing so she could coordinate the flowers and all that stuff, which is just amazing to me that was even something he felt like he needed to do.
It was. But
he knew it would make you happy if you were dressed okay. Yeah. And you were dressed beautifully.
Well, and you know, a couple weeks ago, I got my hair done.
I remember. Yeah.
Well,
so you look gorgeous.
Thank you. That was all part of the plan that I didn't even know about. It was very important to him that I had my hair done first and that I had gone to get, what do you call that? You know, get your toes done and all that kind of stuff.
Mani-pedis. Yep.
Yeah. And he made all of that happen. Because he's just really, really good.
Proper pampered. I like it. You got you proper pampered. I like it.
Yes. And that's not something I do. So when he's insisting that I get it done, and I don't know, it was.
Who are these names popping up on the left side of my screen? Like Sheila was just it popped up, but I don't see her in the chat.
Was it up here?
Yes. Yes.
Michael must be in here somewhere.
So those are the sponsors. Then the names, remember I said I bought
them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, those are the sponsors. And we have a couple new sponsors now that I've got to go in and fix that.
Oh.
Because it's not an automatic thing. It's something I have to do manually. So when you see those names, there's actually a couple extra names that belong in there. And now they will be here soon.
Oh, I love these designs. Now, see, I do this with glue and paper to do my collaging for my journals that I'm making.
Yes.
So I can write the family stories in it for the grandkids. But yes. I love this. I want to get messy with the jelly plate thing. Looks so fun.
It is really fun. I think it's fun.
Well, and it's not just the blue. It's what you put it on. And if you imprinted like this blue you're bringing out now with the design, what was that? A stencil or was it something you pressed on it?
So this one right here that
Okay.
So that is actually a stencil.
Yeah.
That is a stencil on. So paint it's on
gorgeous.
The jelly.
Yeah.
And the stencil on top of that. Then you put this on top of the stencil and you pull out. So everywhere that there's the lines, that's the stencil blocking the paint. And just the paint in between came onto the deli paper. Then when you put it down like this, it becomes see-through because it's deli paper.
Love it. Jules, I missed one day. That'll teach me to actually have other work I have to do occasionally.
If it's possible, don't ever go to work.
There should be a law. You know, work can never interfere with fun. That should be a basic
human I know.
I totally agree with that. All right,
okay. I got to order those deli sheets. I see it on Amazon on my other screen.
Yeah, that's what we're getting because they're a lot of fun to use. You want to make sure you're getting one that is unwaxed or at least unwaxed on one side.
Okay. Okay. I will look at that.
That will help with the...
Because otherwise it would just slip off eventually.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it here?
Print on it, yeah.
Okay. I do not need another blue Yeti. I love this.
All right. What I love about this one has copper in it. Can you guys see that copper?
Yes. Yes.
I always think dark blue and copper go great together. So,
Yes,
they do.
That's a good add. Also, I'm using this matte medium. I always get questions about this. All that copper and shimmery paint and stuff doesn't really get subdued too much. This is very, very shiny right here.
Mm-hmm.
And that's with the matte medium on it. See how it's catching that light?
Yeah.
That's very shiny. In person, it is that bright.
And so I do have matte medium, and we're using this instead of something like Mod Podge or something.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of the Mod Podge. I've said this before. I know lots of people who like it and they enjoy it. And the formulas have changed a little bit over the years, too. So there are some different ones out there that will probably work for you if that's what you like. But I personally am not a fan.
I have this stuff that you've got. And I have the Mod Podge. So hard to say that sometimes.
Yeah.
And I found that it was always sticky when you were done, even days later. So I had to seal it with a matte sealer. Well, why not just use this stuff to begin with, was my thought.
With Mod Podge, the glossy does stay sticky pretty much. The matte mediums archival, the Mod Podge yellows over time.
Yes. And if you're going to put all this work and energy into this, maybe you don't expect it to be around 100 years, but you'd at least like it to not yellow before you stop living.
Or if you happen to like do something seasonal and you put it away until the next Christmas, you don't want it stuck to whatever else it was laying next to.
So true. And I've had things when I first started doing things long before I was ever on YouTube, I was doing some projects for a family member. And then I went and visited them like, I think it was maybe a year later, not mm-hmm. even a year. It was less than a year later. Mm-hmm. And that thing is hanging in their dining room, and it's this dingy looking, like, you know how the old photos would yellow over time?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And
50, 60 years later, those yellowed prints, right? Mm-hmm. This is less than a year later.
That's really
That's quick. Not good.
No,
unless you're going for the antique-y look.
Yeah.
That's what made me change it. But look at this print. That print is amazing, isn't it?
Those colors, these are my favorite colors.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah. And I love those different things you press down.
Yeah, the stencils, the textured plates, yep, all of that. So much fun. And you can use anything. Yesterday we used netting from vegetables or something like that.
I have something like that that the tangerines came in.
Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly. Save that kind of stuff. It makes cool textures on your gel plate. And then if it doesn't work out, you throw it away. I mean, it was going there anyway. So
yeah, can't hurt it.
Nope.
And I think that's what I get from you when you do jelly paints, is that it's an experiment and it's a delightful surprise, the results.
Totally.
I love those tangerine sacks. They make great storage things. You staple them along the front of your desk and it makes like a little hammock thing. You see through, you can reach right up and pull them out.
I love that idea. We're getting all kinds of advice from him today.
Didn't you do something like that with our, I remember something about that. You demonstrated that or showed that, didn't you, Andrew?
Yeah. It's been what, almost 3 years, I guess.
I think so.
I think that's a brilliant idea.
Yeah. He's like, I have an idea to share. And I'm like, okay, Andy, what is it? And it was genius.
Yes. That's why we keep you around, Andy.
Well, I'm glad to finally know the reason.
So it's those flashes of brilliance you get once every 3 years or so.
Yeah, they get interrupted by mediocrity a lot of the time, but I don't care.
Oh, we love you. We do. That's why I like your user-to-users group. When I have been in a total panic trying to go live in 5 minutes and something wasn't working, you guys talked me back off the cliff.
Yes.
It's a good collaboration.
Yeah, it's like that. You come to us for help, and if I can't help you in the first 5 minutes, then I'm going to go ahead and push you off the ledge anyway.
I was just trying to swallow when you said that. I'm going to have to watch it.
Cool. Katie says she's got some vinyl wallpaper that she's thinking of painting on the back of.
Ooh, that's a good idea.
That's going to look great.
I use lining paper, which is like wallpaper, but it's got no pattern on.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, that's cool.
It's really cheap, and it's good for the little one to just splash all over on when we get to that stage.
Right.
It's only a couple of quid a roll, so it's great.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right. I think I've covered just about everywhere I need to. I'm guessing, and I hope I'm guessing right, that the sunflower is going to cover this general area. So I probably didn't need to put too much there. It's going to be covered.
Mm-hmm.
Save your bits. I started tearing this page up and going, hey, that's all I have left. Wait. I want that. It does help. Here's a tip. And I think I said this yesterday, but it does help if you put all the pieces that your work, when have your jelly plate session. Don't worry about colors other than make sure you're using the colors you want to use in your collage. You definitely want to do that. But don't worry about, okay, now I have to do all the blues. Now I have to do all the yellows. Don't worry about that part. Then once you're all done, you go and you separate everything. And if you did something like this, where you've got like a darker, this could be used for the center of the of the sunflower, and this would be the second part. You can just tear this apart.
Bitties, bitties.
Hi, Michael.
Bitties. What did was?
He's seen.
When it goes off, I feel really bad for Jules. It's so. I feel really bad for you. I'm so sorry.
Maybe we could record it. And then she could just push a button if we send her one of those Elgato, whatever, thingamabob stream decks. Whatever. Whoever makes it. I don't know.
Yeah. Peanut butter and jelly from Michael. That's
good. Yeah.
So just keep your, just then you just put all of your blues in one pile, all your yellows in one pile and all that kind of stuff. And then you know when you go to do each section, you'll have your paper separated. Now I can move all my blues away, and you can actually put these like into a folder, store them into like a filing folder, and they'll stay flat. And then you can have them. I mean, I want to pretend I'm that organized. I'm really not, but I would like So here's greens.
I have a confession to make.
Okay.
I picked the deli sheets that I wanted from the list on Amazon. When I click across the top, it says, "You purchased this item on September 19th, 2019. It means it's somewhere in my craft room and I haven't seen it.
Oh, now that's hilarious. Thank you, Amazon, for saving me the money. Now I can go to my room and find it.
Yes. Oh, dear.
That's hilarious.
So you're using scissors.
Please don't, Jules. I promise I will fix it. I promise. Yes, Mert. Yes, you were saying. Please move.
You're
on.
Using scissors now. That's because you need it to be a leaf shape.
Yes, because it's easier for me to cut a leaf shape than it is to try and tear one.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I want you to see that the look doesn't really, like, discourage the end result. I like it. I'm doing really, really big. Here's a tip. Unless you have a pattern, like, for those of you who have ever quilted, there's a lot of quilt patterns out there in the world, so you could actually use... If you don't want to quilt anymore, you're not capable of quilting anymore, and you'd rather switch to something like paper, a lot of that stuff translates really well here. And you can use those patterns. You could trace the pattern onto your paper, and then you could cut that out, and then you would just do this. So you wouldn't have to worry about the seam allowance or any of those things that you would have to do with quilting. But I like to do kind of more freeform. It makes me less stressed, especially when we're doing a live episode like this. And so what I do is I tend to cut out the biggest leaf possible, and then I can trim it once I realize that's kind of massive. Not go bigger. You cannot go bigger. I mean, you can glue little bits and pieces, but it'll bug you, I promise. So
you're having a mini hurricane there. There's some wind factor playing in on that leaf.
So what happens here is my computer, since it's summertime, and we're in the hundreds already by 9 a.m. So my computer has tended lately to become overheated.
Okay.
It has to be directly on the computer, and it turns out it's blowing right over my workstation.
Okay, I get it. I just thought this was a recurring theme when you had the hurricane for your wedding vow ceremony renewal.
No, that was also a wonderful little bonus. Wasn't that a nice little bonus?
We loved it. It was a good variable. Yeah.
So I'm just cutting various leaf shapies out of this stuff. And... I like
Have you tried one of those cooling pads that you sit your computer on, has the double rotating fans to suck the heat out?
Yes. Yes. I believe you actually bought me one.
Okay.
Back in September 2019, and she can't find it.
No, it's sitting on it the whole time, but it's still where the battery is, that it's a laptop, remember? So where is in the back section gets so hot, I'm afraid it's going to bulge out and explode.
Yeah.
So I keep the fan blowing on it whenever I'm using it, especially when I'm streaming, and that has changed everything. It doesn't do the loud airplane sound. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It doesn't do that since I put the fan on. So we have to deal with things blowing away so the computer doesn't explode. I hope everyone.
Okay. That explains it.
Okay. So these are some leafy shapes that we're cutting out. I'm going to cut out a few of them out of this one. I love this patterning on that. I'm going to go
gorgeous
and see it. And it has some shimmer to it because I used sage metallics, which I love. All right. And notice how it's not at all perfect.
Looks grand to me.
All right. So here's our leafy shape-ish stuff.
Oh, wow. KD says about the vinyl wallpaper. She says, it's been in her basement since the 70s. My mother bought it and then decided not to use it. So there are three rolls. Wow.
Oh, wow.
That'd be wonderful.
All right. Fan, you're ticking me off at this moment. I can't do this. Aim more at the computer, please.
<It's> only human. Oh.
All right. Ooh, that's kind of cool. All right. Let's do like that.
Wow.
Like that. Okay, so there's an idea of how it's going to go. Remember my sketch? Remember my sketch?
Yes. Okay, makes sense.
All right. Now, I'm not going to glue those down because what I need to do is I need to get the flower so I have the right proportions. So this is the process I go through. I'm telling you there's no wrong way or right way to do this. But this is the process I choose to go through because it feels better to me to create it this way.
Right.
So I'm going to cut. And the shape, the simpler the shape, I think the more fun you'll have. If you try to do this perfectly, you'll upset yourself. And I don't think you want that. This is supposed to be fun and creative, right?
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's the size we want. So we're going to try and stick with making as many of those as we can.
I may have to do something like this.
It is intriguing, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I'm thinking of a blue sunflower. And you fold the leaves, so half of it's pasted down and half of it stands up. So the inside of the leaf could be like blue, and then the outside of the leaf could be like a bluish green, and then make the center something, some other color, you know. But the leaves, the petals would be blue instead of yellow.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, I want to see this. Like, when can you get this done?
I don't know. That's just another one of my crazy ideas, you know.
Wow.
I love it. It sounds crazy and it sounds amazing.
Well, yes, things don't have to be an exact representation thereof. Mm-hmm. It's the essence of it, you know?
Yep.
It's a suggestion of it. And that's what makes it interesting when people can think outside the box.
All right, so I'm going to move the leaves for just a second so I can keep them from blowing off of my paper here. If I could pull this down a little bit. The computer, the fan is blowing to the computer right here, and that's what the problem is. But anyway, okay. Let's just see how we're doing here. I'm trying to figure out how big or how many.
Yeah, and how big the center. That's what you're working on now.
Really want it to be much bigger. I think it's going to have to be. Now, another way you could do this, if you're having a hard time with the fact that this is not very perfect, you could always trace something to make a more perfect scent circle, you know, that kind of thing. But I love the organic of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's my preference. This is definitely going to be the center. Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to do it like this. So this is the top. So this seems like it's the highlighted mm-hmm. portion. These are going to be that's the way that's going to go. So these need to be much smaller. So now that we've got this idea of the size.
You're jockeying for proportions, figuring out what fits. Yeah.
Yep. And what I'm happy and comfortable with.
Okay.
Yep. Still needs to be smaller. And I kind of want a more rounded leaf. Because if you look at the images of my bouquet,
uh-huh.
It was they're more like sage leaves,
just not fuzzy,
right?
I've just put your Pinterest board, your collage board in the chat.
Thank you. Thank
That's
you.
A good idea. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's see. Okay. Yeah, I think it's going to go like this. I think this is the way we're going to do it. Okay, so I'm going to glue down these leaves. That's where we're going to start.
Okay.
Katie's asking, didn't Matisse turn to collage when he was going blind?
Oh, that's quite possible. I never studied Matisse. I did a lot of Van Gogh and a lot of...
Let me go look that up.
Yeah, that's...
I haven't studied any artists. I just like...
Yes, you have. You've studied our gal here.
Oh, yeah. I study Heather. I've learned a lot from Heather.
Well, me too.
Okay. Learned a lot from Heather and Lucy and Cece and I can't even think of anybody. Lindsay the Frugal Crafter, Lacry Fine Art. There's a lot of them on YouTube I've learned a lot from.
Those are awesome. All those names are awesome.
The Art Sherpa.
There's Matisse collage collection.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, thank you, Andrew.
It just said when he was ill. I quoted the Wikipedia that when he was ill, when ill health in his final years prevented him from painting, he created an important body of work in the medium of cut paper collage. How very Matisse of you today.
Oh, so cool of that. That is so cool. Thank you for even bringing that up, Katie.
Yeah. I didn't know that. I knew of the artist.
Yeah, I did too. I didn't know he'd done collage either.
He's done some really beautiful pieces.
And that would be Andrew's sister's phone. So nobody has to worry about she doesn't know who it is because she picked it up.
Yeah. And that means when she hangs up, I may get kicked out of here.
Ah.
It's the weirdest thing because we've got the internet and phone bundle type thing.
Yes.
And once we answer the phone, if I'm online, when we hang up, it kicks the modem off. Turns the modem off.
Oh, that's crazy. Off.
It is so infuriating sometimes.
Oh.
That's okay. He says this is like impressionist art.
Very much. Yes. Yeah. Yes. I think that's another reason why I like it is because there's, you know, it's ruleless. You know, yeah. I mean, go ahead. I dare someone to tell me I'm not doing it right. Like that's
my collage and I'll do what I want. Thank you very much.
And, you know, I get people all the time saying, I wish you would do. I've been told about those painting parties, for example, and a lot of those painting party things are kind of, they were popular for a while there. Some of them still are. And a lot of people love doing those, which that's great. No problem. I don't do them. I don't do the, okay, everybody, we're going to all paint the exact same image. And, you know, here's where you put this stroke. Here's where you put that stroke. And then you're going to want to paint a circle. And you're going to want to, you know, I don't like doing that.
Yeah.
I prefer to encourage.
Yeah. This week we're going to do Starry, Starry Night.
Yeah.
And next week.
Well, there it is. She hung like up.
Wow.
So, that's Jules, so I put a link in our private chat. Could you put it publicly? That's, of all the things on this page, that's the painting I like the most of his. It's not paper piecing, but it shows, it's pretty. I hope people like that.
I'll put it in now.
Yeah.
And then I'll go and have a look.
Yeah. Thank you.
There's the link.
Makes it back in.
This is Matisse.
Oh, it won't let you put the whole link there.
No, it's just brought up his wiki page.
Yeah, that's okay. It's all good. I'm just looking for a paper collage thing, and I don't see one. But that doesn't mean he didn't do them. I mean, they just aren't here in this collection. Okay, I close that page. We're back to the deli squares. I'm going to sit back and relax. Wow. I turned away, Jules, for just a minute. Look.
Yeah, that's what happens. I can't delete that link I've put in.
It's okay. Well, they can copy the whole thing if they wanted, not just the clickable part.
I'll copy it again into my browser and save that. Okay.
Did you do some paper collage on the little yellow bird that you sent me, Heather?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. It's downstairs in my craft room. It's very inspirational.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I think that started as a napkin collage.
Mm-hmm.
So we started that one and then painted on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, I got to get the brown circle out again, make sure I'm staying. Whoops.
Is it the family scene with the garden in the background?
Yes, where somebody's playing the piano.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes. I'll save that.
I just think it's interesting. Not your typical view of things, you know. Yeah. It's still impressionistic and yeah.
Let's see if this works. No, it's not going to let me do it.
That's okay. Well, it's sort of, if you can copy and paste that whole URL, it sort of looks like the dad's on a tablet. I know he's really holding a cup of coffee, but from my 21st century view, I thought that was a tablet he had in his hands.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
If anybody can copy and paste that link into your browser, it'll open up to the wiki page and then it'll enlarge to the picture Mert's on about.
Oh, I just love that piece you just placed with the variation in shades of yellow going to orange.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's the other thing when you, I mean, that's just a brayered page. So, you know,
that was your waste. Yeah. And
yeah,
it's
this
good.
Is waste, and it's not at all waste. That's why I love jelly plating.
Wow.
Because waste doesn't exist when you jelly plate.
Yeah.
How do I delete my own link, Heather?
I don't know.
No, it's not letting me.
I would think you would just write, there's like a three dots or something, isn't there? I don't
even
know.
The dots aren't showing up.
Oh, well, it's been weird the last couple of days. Everything.
I've got it.
Okay.
I have to click on my name.
I'm auditioning some papers to see if I want to use those. They're too different, I think. So we'll just stick with these brayered off ones for this row. And then I think those lighter ones, that brighter yellow is going to go on the inside. The inside row. And because I don't want this to go 7 or 8 hours, we're probably going to stop at some point soon. And we'll just carry back on tomorrow.
I love it. Tomorrow, I can't meet with you. I'm going to miss it, so I'll have to look on Instagram.
Oh, Instagram. I didn't even think about Instagram today. And you may, if you did see Instagram, you might have seen that I said from inspiration to disaster, and I took a picture of my desk.
But yes.
Then I pulled up just before we went live, so I wanted to show what it looks like now.
Yeah, you didn't upload that one yet.
No, I didn't. All right, so check this out. Here we go with this.
Lucy's laughing. She says, oh, yeah, that's funny. It does look like he's on a tablet.
Yeah. So Henri Matisse was ahead of his time.
Yeah. All right, so I'm using the brush to flatten this out because this is kind of a thicker copy of paper. I prefer to use the cheapest copy paper possible.
Okay.
This is actually better copy paper than, like this would be higher end print paper.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's a little thicker and it makes it a little tougher to glue down.
Right.
Wow.
It looks like it's going to stay, so we're good. And I'm just using the brush to sort of like squeegee out any air bubbles.
Mm-hmm.
And a number one negative effect of this process is air. If air gets trapped under any of these, that's when you have bubbles and things rip and tear, and you don't want that. So use as much of your glue / paint medium as you can.
Mm-hmm.
On the underneath, and then press out. See, you can probably see there's like an air bubble right here. I don't know if you can see that or not, but I just use the brush to push, and then it just pushes the air bubble to the edge, and there it's gone. Just like that.
Good.
Now,
that was a lot to do in 1 hour.
I do want to clean up something here because some of the black or dark brown or whatever this color is on here is coming off on the brush. Right here, it's kind of dirty.
Oh, okay.
So I've got a wet baby wipe. I'll just wipe that off gently so I don't tear the paper.
Oh, that's a good trick.
And we're good to go. Now, here's another tip. When you are doing collage, the more you rub over it with the brush, the more and more and more you do, the more you're tearing at this paper.
Mm-hmm.
Because these are thin, we want them to be as thin as possible so we can collage. It's better at this point in time to actually stop and to let it dry, because at this point you could cause more damage and start ripping your image, and you don't really want to do that. So
no.
We let it sit, we let it be. Tomorrow will be a new day. We're actually going to go in with some of these brighter yellows, I think, and make some littler pieces to go on top, so we'll have that layer. So to have more depth, and then we'll talk about how to finish it up and add the wow factor, because right now it looks kind of cool. It reminds me of, there's an author named Eric Carlisle. I think I said his name right. He did the caterpillar book.
Oh, the Hungry, Hungry Caterpillar.
Yes. This reminds me of those illustrations in those books, which is cool. There's nothing wrong with it, but I want to take it to a more mature level. I want to go to the next level with it. So that's what we're going to do tomorrow. So come back tomorrow. We will see the rest of this. Do an Instagram picture I got from Katie. Yes, ma'am. I am going to right now share with Instagram my cleaned up desk before this moment right now, because it is not clean now.
But while she does that, can I just read this comment that Katie says?
Yeah,
she says, pictures is there is a video on YouTube called Matisse, the cutouts, if you're interested in watching it.
Ooh, that sounds cool, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. It does.
Okay, I'm searching for that. I have to get some work done. I can't just play all day. Yay.
I obviously have a lot of work that I have to do, including changing that sound for Jules. I'm trying to get a picture so you can see that there's still some shine left from the shimmery paints that are in
mm-hmm,
here.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys can see that. I want you to know that the shimmer hasn't disappeared. Yeah. And it's a little easier once it's dry, but we will add that as well as, whoops. Okay, hang on. Maybe not. I have to go to Instagram to do it. Derp. Okay, so we'll go ahead and show. Okay, my phone just decided to stop doing all things that I was asking it to do. So one second here. I'm turning it. You don't have to be so pretty.
Oh, wow. It looks like Lucy's been doing loads of more masks while she's watching.
Wow.
She's a clever girl, Lucy.
Okay, yep. Here we go. Now we're going to post. And there'll be two pictures for you to swipe through, so...
I agree with Katie. I love it on Instagram. I mean, I'm here in StreamYard. I'm looking at Twitch with the volume off so I can comment over there. But I really like Instagram.
Yeah. And I think that was by far the greatest thing that T-Dog ever did. He when he started helping me, he's like, Mom, why don't I take pictures for you so that way people can see the stuff up close? And I think I was doing it myself beforehand, but it's kind of a pain to like stop the show, grab the thing, get glue and paint all over my phone. And then, you know, when he stopped helping, it was like, I still need to do that because it's vitally important, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So there we go. There we go. You should be able to.
Oh, it's come up. Yeah. Oh.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
that's just awesome.
See how bright it is and how cheerful that is. I cannot wait. I'm going to actually do a few of these. So I may work still on two more bases to get them to this stage, because what I want is to have three. One I'm going to give away to Heidi for all of her help and just as a thank you for what she did for me this weekend. And then the other two are going to go up on the website so somebody could take them home if they'd like. So,
oh, brilliant.
All right.
Good idea.
So, all right. I'll get going. And you guys have a crafty day. We'll see you tomorrow. Does that sound good?
Yeah. Bet. Bye.
Thanks, right. Everyone. Bye.
Bye.
Looking closely at what? I thought this was a family show. What did I do wrong?
You misspelled Kraaft.
Guesstimate where it's going to be. Let me cut this. Wow. That was fun. You guys are just... Wow. Excuse me while I catch my breath. I just freaked myself out. Okay. Everybody take a moment. Holy smokes. That was a little scary.
Now I'm going to use... I'm so glad you can't see what I just did. Okay, and then... There's a big box behind me and it was in my way, so...
And... Let's see how this one goes, because I'm really not sure how this one's going to play out, especially because my glitter is not coming out. Looking for a plan B. Okay. just got to laugh because that's hilarious right there. I wish we had instant replay in slow motion because that is flipping hilarious. Okay.